Thanks for joining us once again. That was an absolutely beautiful choral piece from the, what did you call it?
You don't know your Latin?
No.
Schola Cantorum Detroitensis.
I asked Father Mario to take the pronunciation of that one, but the music was, of course, moving to our souls. We have one final segment of the evening, and I'm really excited about this one. I guess I've been excited about every single one. But in the Archdiocese of Detroit, especially over the last few years, if you've been paying attention, you have noticed a significant difference in the way that the Archdiocese communicates with the lay faithful in a very intentional way to help us all be joyful missionary disciples. Our final segment tonight is going to highlight the work of the department that makes that possible and that has made this night possible, which is our communications department. They help to bring the works of each of the ministries in Southeast Detroit present and on the forefront of each of our minds. Here are some highlights of the work of the Department of Communication.
Mary, there are so many wonderful ways that the Archdiocese of Detroit is unleashing the gospel on the digital continent, in print media, and in so many different ways. And so many talented individuals go into making all of this possible. But we know that at the head of every good team is a wonderful leader. And so we welcome tonight the director for the Department of Communications, Mr. Edmundo Reyes. Good evening, Edmundo.
Hey, Father Mario, Mary, good to see you guys.
You too.
I want to thank you for hosting tonight. You guys should have your own podcast. You're very good.
I see what you did there.
I got dumped, but we'll move on. So Edmundo, you know, communications is an essential part, obviously, of unleashing the gospel. And so, so tell us, you know, what is or how does the work of communication tie into this missionary call that we have in our archdiocese?
Yeah, great question, Father Mario. I'll say a couple things. So if you think of what we really want to do with Unleash the Gospel, right, with the missionary transformation of the Archdiocese, it's not just about our parishes, not just about our schools, but it's about all the people, all the souls, all the men and women that live in Southeast Michigan. So that's a lot of people, right? We're talking about more than 3 million people. So we can do that through ministries, through the work of our parishes, through the work of our schools, like I said, but also we need to leverage media and communications through that. So I sometimes think of our team as providing air support for the work that we do on the ground with our parishes, ministries, and so we get to go out there and do it at scale, and we're able to inspire people, we're able to point people to Christ, and it's very exciting, and we get to have all the fun. We do it with all kinds of medium, you know, with podcast and video and written word and magazines, so... we try to do it in a way that is professional, in a way that is engaging, and we're trying to advance the mission.
It was funny watching that highlight reel. There's just so much to be proud of in terms of what you're doing visually. I just read the other day about how the arts and visual things like that are true windows into what the Holy Spirit is doing and who God is. And I can sense that there's a work of the Spirit through the different things that you're doing within the Department of Communication. So I have a question though. Obviously we've asked so many people, we've had to shift and pivot because of the pandemic in the last 6 months. In what ways did you see as a director of the Department for Communication, your team or the work that you're doing really rise to the occasion?
It was awesome to see the team really just realizing we're going to have to do a lot in a short amount of time to serve the people of the Archdiocese. I thought that I'm very, very proud of everyone that works in our department, video producers and writers and reporters, journalists. There are many, many people that make things possible, but they all understood that we had a task that we needed to accomplish, and they went to work. And I mean, for a number of weeks, we were working every day of the week, long days, trying to get all the information out that we needed to get to help the people of the Archdiocese with information regarding the pandemic, the mass, the suspension of public masses, but also bringing a lot of good content out there because people were at home. And we were charged with bringing that content to them. So, you know, I looked at the other day at the statistics that we got for during the Easter, Lent and Easter. We had about 800,000 people that we were reaching during those months. So it's pretty remarkable. We actually ended up doing more content than we did before the pandemic. So we ended up, despite all the limitations, we just ended up producing a lot more content. We created this series called Spiritual Closeness. So we had social distancing, but we wanted to remind people that God is near and God is with us. And we try to do that in the most effective way. So I'm sure you guys saw, you know, or are still, you know, seeing the or watching and participating in celebration of the masses via live streams. We had rosaries. We had a Lenten retreat. So there was so much going out with live streams and serving the people of the Archdiocese. It was very moving for us as a team just to see the comments that people were leaving on social media, just being very grateful that we were able to do that during those difficult days. And we're still getting some of those comments because not everybody's able to participate, you know, of the regular life of our parishes because of health concerns and things like that. So grateful to be able to do that. It was an honor, and it was just a joy to work with my team to make all that thing possible.
Edmundo, a lot of your work focuses on kind of the, as you mentioned, kind of the broad scope of communications for the diocese. But what people might not know is that you also help in the work of communications for parishes. And so I know in my own parish, St. Aloysius in Detroit, in the time of the pandemic when you had so many other things going on as well, you know, your team kind of helped me get a new website up and running to get content on it. And then also helped us to get just live stream working for the parish as well. And so can you just speak to some of those ways that your team is working to help parishes?
So you can think of our team as a full service marketing communications agency that we're serving parishes, schools, ministries, and obviously the departments and offices of the Archdiocese. So we get to do all kinds of projects for them. So crisis communications and PR and media relations. So we help a lot of our parishes with that. We help ministries with not just doing reactive communications, but proactive. So improving their messaging. And in your case, Father, with your parish, we're able to launch that website. We do work for the seminary. You know, whenever an office has any particular need in terms of promotion or marketing, we want to help them with that. So we have a number of specialists. So these are very, very talented individuals that could be out there in the world with very exciting jobs, but they've chosen to be part of our work here in the Archdiocese because they believe in the mission. And all these specialists combined, we're able to bring really good services to the Archdiocese. So one of the things that I try to, you know, just when I talk to my team and talk to other people about our team, you know, we need to understand that we live in a world where there's tons of content out there. There's so many types of content and volume of content just competing for people's attention. So just because we're the church, people are not going to pay attention to us anymore because it's just hard to compete. So we need to raise our standards. We need to communicate with excellence. We need to be creative. Our things need to stand out. So when we do a magazine or when we do a podcast, we're not really competing with other dioceses or other churches. We're really competing with multi-million dollar corporations, media corporations that are trying to grab people's attention. So we want to do our best job, and you can only do that with talent, but also hard work and with disciples. And those are the three really characteristics of our team. You know, we want to work with disciples, we want to work with people that are very good at what they do, and we want people to work really, really hard because the mission is best.
Those were things, Edmundo, that I didn't realize some of those things that your office is responsible for. So what an immense amount of work. I wanted to ask you specifically about the Unleash the Gospel magazine, because I remember it coming to my house for the first time and being like, this is a diocesan publication. It just wasn't what I was used to in terms of any work that I've seen, even at a national level, in terms of something that comes to parishioners' home, the quality and just level of professionalism within it. So what was the genesis of that magazine? How did it come about? It's so well done. Every time I see it, I'm just blown away.
I agree.
You're proud.
Award-winning magazine. Yes. It's an award-winning magazine. It won first prize as Diocesan magazine this year. We're very, very proud of it. You know, there's this saying, right, in communications, you know, that the medium is the message, right? And the type of quality that we're putting out there in the magazine communicates that faith matters, that your faith matters, that Christ matters, that the mission matters. So you're receiving in your homes these, you know, perfect bound magazine, and everything that is in the magazine is built for the magazine. So it's not built, but designed and created for the magazine. So photography and art and all the pieces that are written there, we're thinking about the people of Southeast Michigan, right, on the Archdiocese of Detroit and our mission that we have, and how can we advance it? So it's a mix of things that you would normally not see on a diocesan publication, but you would see it on a regular consumer magazine. So you would see great art, great illustration, great content. I want to tell two stories about the magazine. So this is, you know, the awards are fine, but these are the things that matter to me. So when we were talking to a bunch of priests, so we had this gathering of priests, the Presbyteral Council, and I was presenting about the magazine, and I presented some statistics and things like that. One of the priests came to me at the end of the meeting and said to me, Edmundo, I'm going to tell you something. Last week, one of my parishioners came to confession And she said to me that she hadn't been to confession in more than 10 years. And the reason why she came to confession is because she read an article in the magazine that, that you guys published, and that's what made her go back to confession. And she said to me, if that's the only fruit of the magazine, everything that you guys are doing would be worth it. And I agree with him. And yeah, that was very moving. And that's just one of the ways that we see that we're changing lives, and we do that through the collaboration of all these great artists and writers, but also I know the Holy Spirit is working through us. The other compliment, you know, it's a very, very striking magazine. So if you don't get it in your homes, you know, make sure that you, if you make a donation, we're sending it to all the people that support the mission. We're sending it now every 3 months. It was every 2 months, but we're switching to 2 months. So the latest issue is this one. But the biggest compliment that somebody gave me, besides this priest, was that not only it looks beautiful, but I read it cover to cover. So it took me some days to get there, but I felt that all the content was valuable to me. So those are the things that we like to hear. I think that it's different. And again, the medium communicates something. The medium is a message. Our faith matters. A publication like that, I hope that everybody that gets it in their homes is proud of being part of the Archdiocese, is part of their faith, and would want to share it with other people. You can pass it around. You can give it to your children, to your neighbors, to your loved ones after you read it. I think it has a lot of value.
Edmundo, we've been asking all of our departments, and so we're going to ask you the same question here tonight. How you're going to keep your team busy coming up this fall, most especially with the Detroit Catholic and also Unleash the Gospel. So what can we be looking for in the next couple months?
We are super excited. In a few weeks, sometime in October, God willing, we're going to be launching our third podcast. So we have two award-winning podcasts. So I think you guys are familiar with at least one of them, Mary. I would imagine you know. Yes. Ice and Jesus podcast with the Archbishop, and you are the host. And then we also have opened our policy. But this month, in October, we're going to be launching a third podcast. Is going to be on Detroit Catholic. So Detroit Catholic, when you think of our news publication, that's the place where we tell stories, right? The stories that are inspiring, stories that tell what God is doing in our midst, in the life of the Archdiocese, in our parish and schools. So we're going to be doing that in a different format, and we're super, super excited about it. So a new podcast that focuses on storytelling, again, the stories of the Holy Spirit working in our Archdiocese. So we're super, super excited. We also, a year and a half ago or a little bit more, we released a Mass Finder, so a place where people are able to find Masses in the Archdiocese. And, you know, at some point when we anticipate that there's going to be a return to Masses, we're going to be ready with a Mass Finder that is going to be more comprehensive. It's going to have confessions. It's going to have Eucharistic adoration. You're going to be able to find Christian services all in one finder here in the Archdiocese. So it's all going to be location-based, so based on where you are that day or normally where you live, you're going to be able to find all that information for you. You know, we keep publishing magazines, so you're going to continue to see that. And then the other big thing is the Archdiocese, some of you know that Archbishop announced in Pentecost a move to families of parishes. So we're going to be very involved in trying to help people understand what families of parishes is about, why we're doing that, how that's going to affect them in their parishes, and hopefully inspire them and connect them to what God is doing. So we always go back to the source. The source is what God is doing, is the pastoral letter, is the synod. And what is that about? It's about our transformation of Archdiocese. So we would become what God wants us to become, and that's missionary disciples.
Amen. And we know that many of these resources have now been available in Spanish as well. So kudos to you and your team. So Edmundo, can you tell our viewers out there tonight once again how they can make a donation to this ministry and all the ministries that CSA supports?
So you can visit tonight. You don't have to wait until tomorrow to go to www.audgivingday.org, and you can make a gift that will support the mission. So today you had a chance to look at many, many ministries. There's others that are doing great work. So what you're supporting is impact, is people's lives being changed and touched. And you can do that by going to www.audgivingday.org. And you can select your interest, so the area that you're most interested of supporting, and you can let us know about that. So we encourage you to visit this website to make a donation. Some members in our community are not going to be able to make a donation this year because of financial hardship. You know, we're being affected. And so if you are able to, if you could be extra generous, it would be greatly appreciated. Thank you.
Edmundo, thanks so much. And thank you for all the work that you do, particularly its focus on discipleship. We really appreciate it. Tonight has been pretty wild, just the logistics of making this happen. And speaking of logistics, we have to give a shout out to the live stream crew tonight. I can't even believe what they're doing, actually, what they're doing tonight, for their time, for their effort to highlight the amazing work of the different key moments or ministries within the Archdiocese of Detroit. Let's get a behind the scenes look.
Take it away, Andrew. There we go. There we are.
That's us.
All this technology that we're able to use to reach the masses, literally. We're going to go now behind the scenes to, there's Emily. Hi, Emily.
And this is CSA dollars. Like, that's right. So important to be able to put things like this together. Hello,
Ron,
hello.
And Rick. And Paul and Emily somewhere back there behind. There she is.
Fantastic.
But holding on, Ron.
Thanks so much to all the people behind the scenes for their work here tonight. I don't even pretend to begin to understand how this all was able to be live streamed out there. We were able to connect all this sound, and we didn't have any problems with the Zoom calls or anything like that,
which really
is
great.
Pretty
At
amazing.
At least we know. Yeah. I bet back in that room, you guys were probably quite busy, but you done good.
Yeah, this sign of the Holy Spirit.
Exactly.
All right. So you have five kids.
I do.
And you need to wake up with them early
in the
morning.
I know, I'm up so late.
All of these wonderful people here tonight have families to go home to. I had to go to work in the morning as well.
Oh,
and so we're going to wrap it up here tonight. So you've heard it said a million times. We're going to say it one more time. It's truly been a year like no other. Not only have we faced many different challenges, but people on mission for Christ in the Archdiocese have responded in absolutely remarkable ways and with an inspiring spirit of innovation and commitment to serve the people, all the people here in Southeast Michigan and the Archdiocese of Detroit.
You know, we are called to make a difference, but none of us can do this work alone. The work of ministries we've heard from tonight is only made possible by the work of the body of Christ, by your generous support, your prayers, your volunteer hours, and of course, by the gifts of support to the mission. Please consider making a gift tonight. Visit www.aodgivingday.org.
That's right. So we'll say it again. Your support, your prayers, your financial support makes a difference. You touch the lives of so many people. On behalf of Archbishop Vigneron and for all the people here in the Archdiocese of Detroit, we say thank you and good night.
Good night.